All right, well, let's go ahead and we will move to the president's report. Scott?
I'm gonna start with summary of ridership and a projection of reservations this year. Announcing the 2022 schedule November 15th and opening the website for reservations made a huge difference in early ticket sales. We rebooked or refunded 2,808 tickets due to the delayed opening from June 11 to July 1. And we've exceeded 14,500 reservations as of July 27th. As of the same time in 2019, using that and projecting forward, we should achieve about 31,000 guests, which, taking all of June off the schedule, cost us, if you compare back to 2019, it would have cost us about 14,000 guests. So that delayed opening really impacted the ridership. Also, the Chama water situation significantly impacted the railroad. During the first 2 weeks of July, it seemed like every single reservation being taken, the question was, does Chama have water? And it significantly impacted the reservations being made. Albuquerque TV stations made a lot of noise about Chama not having any water. They didn't make a lot of noise about Chama having water. And that significantly hurt early July ridership. Comparison, if you look at 2019, there were approximately 33,000 riders from July 1 to the end of the season. So we're hoping we can recover at least to 31,000. Group sales represent, as of today, 3,258 compared with 3,808 from 2019. And I want to point out that Amanda has done a remarkable job recovering from essentially complete loss of institutional knowledge on our group sales process due to personnel transitions. We finished the Chama Express in July. It's interesting to see how many more toddlers fill this train. And toddlers come with parents and grandparents. And so we had 326 riders on four trains, largely being families with small children. As we delayed the opening day from Memorial Day weekend to June 11 for the Osier fire recovery, that played out to allow us some time to rebuild parts of Osier. The extreme fire danger led the commission to delay the opening further until July 1, based on a recommendation I made to the commission. And it impacted the railroad's revenue, we estimate about $750,000. Based on the economic impact study that we did last year, the impact of the five-county region is probably about $2.6 million. So it was a significant hit to the surrounding county. And in talking with members of both legislatures and representatives of the New Mexico Governor's Office, the commission has been thanked several times for taking the action of delaying the opening. We don't know if the legislatures will step in and help us with financial recovery or not, but they might be inclined. But that has been a significant impact to the region.